Hello dear students, myself Ganga Bhusle, your statistics teacher. Today we are going to learn binomial distribution. There are some assumptions for binomial distribution. First one is the number of trial is fixed and finite. Here we say that n. Each trial results only in two ways, that is success or failure. Here by printing mistake, this is our success. Okay, the probability of success is p and the probability of failure is q. That is, the probability of success is denoted by p and the probability of failure, that is q. From this we get p plus q is equal to 1. P plus Q is equal to 1. All the trials are independent. Under these assumptions, probability mass function, that is P dot M dot F, of binomial distribution is defined as, if capital X denotes the number of success in n trials satisfying the above assumptions, the probability R successes is given by P of x is equal to r is equal to n c r dot p raised to r dot q raised to n minus r. That is, this is formula for probability mass function. When r is equal to 0, 1, 2 up to n and the value of p lies between 0 to 1, that is, and p plus q is equal to 1. And is equal to 0 otherwise. Here n and p are called parameters of the binomial distribution. N is also known as degree of distribution and can be expressed as x follows binomial distribution with parameters n and p. X follows binomial distribution with parameters n and p. There are some properties of binomial distribution. The mean of binomial distribution is NP, N dot P. Then the variance of binomial distribution is NPQ, NPQ. This is our variance. And the standard deviation is under root NPQ. Since 0 less than P less than Q and 0 less than P less than 1, we get here NP is greater than NPQ, that is, mean is greater than variance. Now, third one, if each of N trials is repeated capital N times, then the expected frequency of successes in capital N trials is equal to N dot P of X is equal to R, that is, N dot P of X is equal to R. This is our P of x is equal to r, that is n c r p raised to r q raised to n minus r. Now we see uses of binomial distribution. First one, if all the assumptions are satisfied, then binomial distribution can be used in the problems involving, first one is the tossing a coin head or tail, the results of an examination pass or fail, the result of an election, elected or not elected. Fourth one is the result of inspection of an item, defective or non-defective. Okay. Now we see example of this binomial distribution. Sorry, if capital X is a binomial variable such that capital N is equal to 4 and 25 dot P of X is equal to 3 is equal to P of X is equal to 1. For P of X is equal to 1, in sim on page number 136, they are typing like this, P X is equal to 1. But this is wrong. This is our P of X is equal to 1. Okay. And here here we have to calculate the values of p and q, p of x is equal to 0 and mean and variance. So here we calculate. For the solution, first we write, let capital X follows binomial distribution with parameters n and p, the probability mass function as, then the probability mass function, that is p dot m dot f, as p of x is equal to r. What is the formula p of x is equal to r? That is n c r p raised to r dot q raised to n minus r. Okay, for r is equal to, here the number of n is equal to 4, so we get r is equal to 0, 1, comma 2, comma 3, comma 4. Then we calculate first one, that is the value of p and q. Here given that the value of n is 4 and capital N, that is 25, p of x is equal to 3 is equal to p of x is equal to 1. 25 into p of x is equal to 3 is equal to p of x is equal to 1, which implies 25 into p of x is equal to 3, that is here r, the value of r is 3. Put out the value of n and r in this formula, so we get 4c3 dot, here we have to calculate the value of p and q, so we write here p raised to r, the value of r is 3, dot q raised to n minus r, that is 4 minus 3, which is equal to 1, which is equal to, here the value of r is nothing but 1, n c r, that is 4c1 p raised to r, that is 1, dot q raised to n minus r, that is 4 minus 1, which is equal to 3, which implies 25 into 4c3, which is equal to 1, and 4c1, which is equal to 1. Okay, so here we get p raised to 3 dot q, which is equal to p dot q raised to 3, which implies 25 into, from this p and p get cancelled, so here we get only p square, which is equal to, and from this q get cancelled, so here we get q square. Okay, now we take square root on both sides, so we get square root of 25 is 5, square root of p square is p, square root of q square is q, so we get 5p is equal to q, and we know the formula p plus q is equal to 1. From this we get q is equal to, that is this implies q is equal to 1 minus p, which implies 5p is equal to 1 minus p, which is equal to, just a minute, so here we get 5p, minus p becomes plus p, which is equal to 1, therefore 5p plus p, which is equal to 6p, is equal to 1. From this equation we get the value of p is 1 by 6. Now we put out the value of p is equal to 1 by 6 in this equation, that is p plus q is equal to 1, implies the value of p is 1 by 6. 1 by 6 plus q is equal to 1, which implies q is equal to 1 minus 1 by 6. Cross multiplies these values, so we get 6 into 1 is 6, 6 minus 1 is 5, 5 divided by 6. So here we get the value of p is 1 by 6 and the value of q is 5 by 6. And we have to calculate the values are our right or wrong. Then just put out the value p and q in this formula. That is p is equal to 1 by 6, q is equal to 5 by 6. From this we get here denominator is same. So we write 6, 1 plus 5. 1 plus 5 is equal to 6, 6 by 6, which is equal to 1. That is p plus q is equal to 1. So the values of p and q are right. Now we calculate second one. For in second we have to calculate p of x is equal to 0. That is the value of r is here 0, which is equal to 4c0. The value of n is 4, 4c0. P raised to 0, q raised to n minus 0, that is 4 minus 0, which is equal to 4c0. The value of p is 1 by 6 raised to 0 dot q is our 5 by 6. 5 by 6 raised to 4 minus 0, which is equal to 4. 4c0 is nothing but our 1 dot anything raised to 0 is 1 dot 5 by 6 raised to 4. So here we get 1 into 1 into 5 by 6 raised to 4 is equal to 5 by 6 raised to 4. Here we write since 4c0 is equal to 1, which is equal to 5 by 6 raised to 4 is 0.4822. Okay, now we calculate third one, and in this third we have to calculate mean and variance. What is the formula for mean? Mean is equal to np. Okay, now n, the value of n is 4 and the value of p is nothing but our 1 by 6, which is equal to multiplying numerator numerator, that is 4 into 1 is equal to 4 divided by the product of denominators, that is 6 into 1, which is equal to 6. When we divide numerator and denominator by 2, we get 2 by 3. Okay? Now, variance. What is the formula for variance? NPQ, which is equal to the value of n is 4 into the value of p is 1 by 6 and the value of q is 5 by 6. Multiplying numerator, 4 into 1 is 4, 4 into 5 is 20, divided by 6 into 6, which is equal to 36. And when we divide numerator and denominator by 4, we get answer 5 by 9. Okay, I hope all of you understood this example. Thank you.